is a burning thing, and it may.
Hey guys.
Hey, welcome back, everybody.
How y'all doing?
How's it going, fries? I'm Kat.
I'm Dog, and we're the Refried Home Fries.
Yeah, we got a lot of noise going on, so forgive that.
We're not Refried Home Fries today. We're the Windblown Fries, because
right.
We're in the middle of a windstorm. I mean, it is bad out there right
yeah.
now. You can hear it all around us.
And we'd have to skip recording, and we didn't really want to do that.
No.
So
just gonna, deal with it.
Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Mother Nature at her finest.
Yeah, this is the Mojave Desert for you. It's always windy.
Mm. Yeah, sometimes just windier than others. So today we are going to do season 4, of course, episode 4.
Yeah, 4-4.
Yeah.
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 Excuse us, we're a little discombobulated.
Opening and...
Excuse me. Yeah, if you watched our previous episode, we did the two opening acts for 1 and 2, episodes 1 and 2. Now what we're going to do is we're just going to include the opening act with whichever episode they're doing their singing for. So that's the way that's going to work. We'll just include both of them together as a single video.
We were all missing out on a lot because we hadn't seen these. So actually after doing it, now we're seeing how much fun.
And
even though it's not really Dog's thing, but it's fun.
It is. So, yeah, let's check this out. This is the opening number for episode 4.
Good stuff.
Talking about my generation.
People try to put us down.
Talking about my generation. Just because we get around. Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Stop it real quick because we got to get to another one. But wow, that's a lot of voices.
It is.
When you start listening, I mean, I'm thinking from the technical, and there's how many people are on that stage right now?
A lot.
20, 30?
Yeah, I don't know how many groups are even left up there because I'm not understanding how it was working.
They had to bring in some expansion carts for these mixing boards for all those mics. Wow.
Well, to me, it's crazy because I can hear now, you can hear Austin in there, you can hear Tim in there with all those voices.
Yep, you can still hear those guys. They're so distinctive. Yep.
And I'd love that coming out because I knew Tim and Adam were going to be there.
Our boy. movies.
Oh my goodness, I love that. How exciting for them, though. I mean, to me, it's always amped me up anyways. That many different personalities and different voices, you know, all on stage together, all that energy, and those right. guys, you know, they everybody there feeds off of it.
Sure. And see, I look at it from a completely different standpoint.
Yeah.
It's like, that's next level engineering going on there, mixing that show live, because all the features, all the vocal spotlights, I mean, you've got to know how many, like I said, how many people, 30 up there, 35, 40, I mean, whatever it is, you got to know when to bring each person up for their solo, for their spotlight, for their features, so they yeah. stand out from the rest of the voices, and then you got to put them back in the mix so that they go back to
do
the
do you
back.
Think it's just like, one engineer, or do you think there's a few of them on a production
team up
like
there.
That? Yeah.
Yeah, there's probably quite a few different people.
Yeah.
And it's all been rehearsed, I'm sure. It's been rehearsed, sure. and they've got pre-programmed
yeah.
patches that do, yeah, a lot of automation for stuff like this, I'm sure. But it's still, it's a technical nightmare. I mean, that's just, wow.
Yeah, and see, we just, most of us just watch it. And me, I've always been one to love, I used to love to dance.
Yeah.
I mean, I still do, but watching the choreography, I just love all that kind of stuff. I get fired up. Yeah, I would have been crying if I was watching this live. I mean, I would have just, yeah, thinking about it all day and run home from work and just in case you do American Idol. Oh, yeah.
I can't wait. Yeah. Don't talk to me. They're on. Don't talk to me.
So is there only four here?
I'm not sure. This is episode number four, so this is the one that...
So maybe three. You guys knew how it worked for those who were around. Maybe three that Homefree wasn't in. There was four... from that group, and then this is four. Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just here to watch him sing.
We're
man.
Just here. Yeah. We're here for Homefree, guys. Honestly. Yeah.
Oh, man. All so right, well, this was their Ring of Fire debut.
Yeah.
On national television. Let's take a look.
Yes.
Well, after a great show last time, our own judge, Ben Foles, decided it was time to get in the mix and personally give our groups their next challenge.
He is back.
Sure, you all wonder why I've called you here. Your assignment is My Generation, chart toppers that span the decades. Talk amongst yourselves, deliberate, and come up with something that's going to kick America's ass.
With all these groups, I found that they each have something that's getting in the way of who they are. And when they clear that out, any of them are unstoppable. Your superpower is being you.
That's words of wisdom.
An audience can learn who an artist has become at the same moment as the artist discovers it. And that's the most powerful thing in the world.
You guys got a lot of work to do, so get to it, and I'll stop by and see how it's going. You ready?
Yeah!
All right, let's get going.
He's so young.
All right, we'll see how Ben tried to help each group show their true colors in just a moment. You're watching The Sing-Off, where some of America's top singing groups are delivering all vocal takes on songs that span the generations. Our first group this evening has staked their claim in the competition with a smooth country sound. We circled round with the five gents of Homefree to see how they plan to fire up a Johnny Cash hit from the golden age of country music.
Homefree has been professional now for the last 5 years, and we do about 200, 250 shows a year. We are always in the RV, and we're always in each other's space. So now the hotel is a lot like the RV without the wheels.
Seriously, another banana in the sink.
I mean, I like the hotel and all, but it's no RV.
Performance went really well. We were surprised at the reception we got again. We couldn't have asked for more.
It sounds so easy when you guys sound relaxed. It sounds like it just comes out of you, but it's deceptively hard. So good job. I love you guys.
For the next performance, we need to bring it again. So we decided to go with the man in black, Johnny Cash.
Ring of Fire isn't necessarily from my generation, but I grew up with it, so it feels like it's a part of who I am.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up?
Ben is easily my biggest influence from the last 20 years.
I talk about artistry of a cappella. The most amazing artists can go out and do something very vulnerable. That's the part that is going to move people. back home. Because winning is reaching and moving people, either by making them laugh or cry or dance or move their butt. So. These guys are technically experienced singers. They go home. It would simply be because with all the technique in the world, they didn't tell us the story.
I feel for you like a child.
Ben said that one way to go is to show our vulnerable side. And we are actually going to try and have like a tender moment. And from then on, make it a little bit more fun. Our version of Ring of Fire is going to set the stage on fire.
Austin's all clean shaven.
Hey.
Performing Ring of Fire by Johnny Cash, here is Home Free.
One, two, three.
And it makes a fiery wind.
And bound by a wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire.
I fell into a burning ring.
Love is sweet, when hearts are like ours beat, and I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild.
Standing ovation. Tim's like, yeah.
Home Free taking on the Man in Black. People in Pasadena just called and reported a seismic event. That was ridiculous. Goodness gracious. Let's go to the panel. Ben. They take your advice? Do they stay true to themselves on that performance?
Oh man, you did it all. You guys opened and you like encapsulated something about the song, which is sad, and it was perfectly executed. And then the middle got fun. Tim, you went from being an instrument this time to being a human. And it was so great. It was, because before you've been like the singing refrigerator guy, like, oh, oh. But this time, like the tree, you know, like the wise tree. Maybe a wise tree is a better, you know. People pass you, like, oh, it's that way. But no, and then the end with that massive heavy low note is just a great way to leave everyone going, holy, what was that? And
yep.
Anyway, that was awesome, guys.
Oh, wow.
Now, Jewel. What'd you think about the version these guys did?
That was sweet. You know, June actually wrote this song when she met Johnny and she was still married, which gives it a lot of heart and a lot of feel of feeling like you're sinning. So that poignancy was really brought out by that beginning. Did I just hear a cappella country reggae?
Yeah.
Is that what just went down here?
Yeah.
That was really great. And I mean, that's like a low F sharp. That's like an octave lower than most men can sing.
Wow.
And I heard those high notes. You're covering over three octaves, it sounds like. I mean, you really have some sick range there, country boy. It's really, really good. I enjoyed it.
So, Sean, they do Johnny Cash justice? What do you
Absolutely.
Think?
Absolutely. Even though you consider yourselves a country a cappella group, you show so much more than that. Adam, with that reggae dance hall beat, I would have never thought of anything like that, but it worked. Like, it absolutely worked. Mm-hmm. Austin,
yeah.
Listen, Your voice is just smooth as butter, bro. Like, honestly, like,
your butter.
There's so many elements to you guys. It's great to watch, and you guys are truly entertaining.
No doubt about it.
Thanks, gentlemen. Very nice job.
Shook the floor, man. Have you ever heard anybody sing that low before? I don't know if I've ever heard anyone hit a note.
The only person I've heard sing that low, honestly, is Mike McCary. That used to be in my group. That was
badass.
That was badass. Yeah.
Love it.
Oh, man, that was...
Wow.
That's great. I love it.
Yeah. Oh, man.
I'm so glad we're doing this.
Well, you know, I'm starting to see a pattern here. And people have mentioned it actually in the comments. And I'm just wondering, at what point are they going to feature Rob and Chris? Because the judges are always complimenting, you know, Tim and Austin and Adam. And
well,
we got to be getting around to those two sooner or later, right?
I don't know that they do, from what I've seen, read. But, you know, Tim is the base. Austin is
the main. I mean, those guys are the hooks, yeah.
It still is that way.
Yeah.
Really. But everybody knows that they're just as talented. It's just, it happens. That's the way it is. Yeah.
Curious.
Without them, it wouldn't be the same. So,
true.
You know?
Very true.
Yeah.
Regardless. Alrighty, guys.
So, all right. Well, thanks for watching, guys. If you're enjoying the series, hit subscribe for us and
please.
Like and share and comment.
And all the fun stuff. Yeah.
And we love you guys. We appreciate you.
We will
see you soon.
Yeah, man. Like, real soon.
Yeah.
Take care.
Take care, guys.